Hello, I'm Jack. Welcome to my channel, Practical Programming with Dr. Su. In this video series, you will learn everything you need to get started with wgpu graphics programming in Rust. In the last video, I explained how to build a simple 3D cube with lighting effect. In this video, I will show you how to add the lighting effect to a sphere as shown here. To do this, we need to use a spheric coordinate system as shown here. Here shows the formula for x, y, and z are related to the r radius, theta, and phi. In the spheric coordinate system, use these relations, x equal to r sine theta cosine phi, y equal to r cosine theta, z equal to minus r sine theta sine phi. The normal vector for a unit sphere is very simple. It is just given by x, y, z coordinates on the sphere, the surface. That is, the normal vector is identical to its vertex positions on the sphere. In the spheric coordinate system, it can be written in this form, just sine theta cosine phi cosine theta minus sine theta sine phi. That is, x, y, z normalized by the r, by the radius. To create a vertex position data for our sphere, we can start with a longitude and a latitude method, also called UV sphere. The sphere can be constructed using the U here and the V ring here. You can see the UV lines forms a grid on the surface of the sphere. In order to generate vertex position data for this surface, it is enough to consider just one unit grid as shown here. Here is one unit grid here, just like here. The unit grid contains four vertices. One is P0, P1, P2, and P3, the four vertices. Here we need to divide this quad-shaped unit cell into two triangles. One is P0, P1, P2. Another one is P2, P3, and P0. It's two triangles. Okay, let's now go to the programming part. Here we will use the data tool to clone the source code used in the last example, and then make corresponding changes to that source code to build the project used in this video. Now let's start Visual Studio Code directly from Windows Start menu here. This is Visual Studio Code interface. Now let's cd into code folder. From this folder, we need to make a new folder called wgpu11. And cd into this new folder. We can then clone the source code used in the last video with the command git clone wgpu turns. After this command, we leave a space and a period. This will place all our source code used in the last video in the current folder. Run this command. We can check direct. You can see the source code is indeed in the current folder. Now we can open this folder from Visual Studio Code open folder code wgpu11. Here contains the source code used in the last video. As mentioned previously, we will use the spheric coordinate system to get the positions on the sphere surface. First, we need to get a point position on a sphere surface. Now add a new Rust file called massfunc.rs to the src folder. Add a new file massfunc.rs. This file will contain the mass functions used to create different 3D objects. First, we need to add a new method called sphere position to this file with the code. This method simply returns x, y, and z position specified with the spheric coordinates as discussed previously. We can now save this file and close it. Next, open the vertexdata.rs file from src folder, vertexdata.rs file. Now we need to add a new function called sphere data with the code add to here. Here you can see we firstly introduce our massfunc module from massfunc.rs file. Then we add a new method called sphere data. This data you can see returns three vectors. First is after three component is for the position. The second is for the normal vector. And the third one is 2, you know, F32, the 2 component here, it will be used for the UV data. We will add this data later. Here we use a sphere position from the mass func to get the position on the sphere. We then use the UV longitude and latitude methods to divide the sphere into UV grids to obtain the vertex position data for our sphere. We only need to consider a single unit cell like this. Here we have the unit cell, we have four vertices. As discussed before, you can see P0, P1, P2, and P3. Then for this unit cell, we need to divide it into two triangles. So we have 6 points for these two triangles. So 6 positions, P0, P1, P3 is one triangle. P1, P2, and P3 is another triangle. For the normal vector of the sphere, they are simply equal to the vertex data normalized by the radius. You can see here the normal vectors. For each vertex, we just x, y, z, we just divide by the r. The first three is for the first triangle. Here is the normal vector for another triangle. So this sphere data methods that returns the position, normals, and UV. UV data will be added to here later. Now we can save this file and close it. Now we need to make some changes to the min.rs file. From src folder, open min.rs file. We need to replace its content with the new code. Here, we first introduce two modules. One is common from common.rs file. One is vertex data from vertex data.rs file. We then define the create vertices function. Inside this function, we generate the position. You can see pulse and normals from the sphere data methods. This function returns the vector of the vertex. You can see vector vertex structure defined in the common.rs file. Finally, we define our main function, which is very simple because we place most code into the common.rs file. Here, we just create vertex data by calling the create vertices methods and the light data from the common light function. Now we can save this file. We can run our example in the terminal window by just using cargo run. Okay, here is our 3D sphere with red color and a white specular light here. We can also make some changes to our light parameters. For example, if we set diffuse and specular light to 0 and set ambient intensity to 1, we will get a sphere with ambient light only. So close this window. We can change the light parameter for an AI ambient intensity to 1 and DI diffusion intensity to 0 and SI specular light intensity to 0. So we can then save this file and rerun the application. We will get this sphere. This sphere has ambient light only. You can see the sphere looks flat and has no 3D feature. Now let's change the parameter back. So let's add diffuse and specular light back. We can also change the diffuse light and specular light colors. For example, change the diffuse color to blue. This to blue 0, 0, 1 to blue, and specular light to green. For example, 0, 1, and 0. Then rerun this application. You can see we get a sphere with blue color with a green spectral light here. Now we have completed this example. In next video, I will show you how to create a 3D torus with lighting effect. Thank you for watching.